Gracious sons and daughters of liberty, freedom, and enlightenment. I, Kuthumi, come to address you in this hour on the dynamic of spiritual activism as it relates to your desire to manifest planetary and personal peace. Many of you have considered how you may make a greater impact on the world at large through your consciousness wed to God as you influence the world scene, attempting to bring tranquility, harmony, understanding, and brother's sisterhood to the nations and her peoples. Long ago, I considered this dynamic and what the Lord conveyed unto me was truly that I personally must become that sacred space of peace through a continual resonance with the frequencies of that light of cosmic Christ peace that so nobly was emanated and demonstrated by the Prince of Peace himself, Jesus the Christ. As I modeled my life after his, as I understood the scriptures by a personal investigation into that which his words represented in a greater context of spiritual gnosis, I understood and then deeply felt the presence of peace abiding within me. I knew in a deeper reality the essentials of how to distribute on frequencies and wave patterns of cosmic consciousness that reverent understanding and presence to all life by becoming one with all life. If you, blessed ones, would consider the higher initiatic path and how you too may employ the gifts of your being, those sacred talents vouchsafed to you by God at the onset of your incarnation upon this beautiful planetary home, you may also join the brothers and sisters of the Golden Robe and initiates in heaven in emanating these cosmic wave patterns that flow from your heart, your soul, your divine spirit, as you choose to emit them by God's grace. The beloved peace, working with Jesus, has offered you a prayer in the 60th section of your prayer book that you may give on a regular basis and invest your energies one with God's to so emanate the light of cosmic Christ peace. For the Elohim peace himself with his aloha, most gently and calmly, are able to harmonize many disparate frequencies as they receive them from the mass consciousness across the earth, transmute them within their dynamic causal bodies, and then ray forth through a gentle wave action of light those cosmic ideations and patterns of peace that bring that equipoise and stillness to the mass consciousness, quelling overt emotionalism that becomes a disturbance within the flow field of souls, that when merging with others who may be angry or in some way objectifying unresolved frequencies within their beings, erupts into some form of violence, chaos, confusion, and eventually war. Blessed ones, the key to the overcoming of war is inner peace within you and within every son and daughter of God across our earth. If each person takes accountability and responsibility to resolve the issues boiling within their own emotional bodies, and at times, if this requires bringing to the surface those boils to be lanced and the energy pockets within them to be released and transmuted, so be it. You see, one such as the Mahatma Gandhi may be your example of how to fast and pray and go within and take that personal accountability in the greater sense of world service. And when you know with a certainty, yea, with a cosmic certitude, that you are in the flame of cosmic Christ peace, then we will work with you on a greater level and lend the momentum of our embodiment of peace to this sacred dynamic to then build that light energy field around the world and to accelerate a greater planetary action of peace everywhere. This is spiritual activism at its finest. Blessed ones, you do not need to enter into the great cities of the world and demonstrate with rancor or with a loud, raucous voice your angst toward governments, toward multinational corporations that you see as ignoring the necessities of individual people across the world and what they do with their power to be overbearing upon humanity and the gentle people of light in all nations. By simply going within, making your attunement, feeling the fire, and then pouring forth the light from your presence through your heart to the world. You are an arbiter of a greater divine destiny. You are a nexus of peace in the eternal now of your consciousness, one with God. This, from the viewpoint of the Great White Brotherhood, is the greatest demonstration that you can make toward the arousing within the subconscious of many of the light of stillness, equipoise, and divine presence. Therefore, practice makes perfect, and the practicing of your presence moment by moment in the silence of stillness allows for cosmic grace to emerge, divine light to flow, pure beingness to grow, and to enfold our earth with this gentle presence of peace, love, and harmony. When Jesus calmed the winds, what was the scientific explanation of how he accessed the power of God to immediately silence the emotional turbulence that manifests as that storm, beloved ones? He could only have accomplished this divine feat through the inner resolve of complete God mastery of himself, knowing every erg of energy within his body temple, and blending the resource of his light with the elementals at large within the nature kingdom to caress them with a new sense of stillness and to allow the abiding light of that divine frequency to calm what had been agitated within the natural world around him. You see, nature responds to the consciousness of mankind. And if you see overbearing winds, if you observe storms, hurricanes, cyclones, tornadoes, and such, it is then time to go within to access the still point of perfect peace within and feel one with that storm and then speak to the precious elementals gently and say, I love you, O my brothers and sisters of the kingdom of nature. Be at peace today within yourselves. I know you, and I know that you deserve better than this, that you deserve to feel valued by mankind, and therefore release the torment that comes unto you into the eternal flame of the sun, for our sun may deal with those energies and frequencies and bring about harmony again. And so the elementals will respond, shaking off that which they have felt as an imposition through the mass consciousness. And yet, those energies may not directly impact your world as we have seen them do so in the past. They may be transmuted by the action of light of the god and goddess Meru and many solar beings upon and within the sun. And when you enter the sun in your meditation, to also be a point of understanding, divine wisdom, compassion, and holy gnosis, you may accelerate the process of the reestablishment of peace here, there, and everywhere within the natural kingdom of mankind, the elementals, the Elohimic evolution, and those sacred places where angels do not fear to go, for they are wrapped in light and teeming in the spirit of peace, divine love, and presence. Gentle ones, it is time for more of mankind to awaken to the truth of who they are, God's sons and daughters, living in eternality within the schoolroom that you call Earth. It is time that you, as a teacher, as a light worker and a sharer of our teachings, assist the world teachers in enlightening and edifying many through your lives lived to the glory of God and your divine example of one who has embodied peace, love, and tender care and regard for all life. As you model a reverent one, we will bestow through your awareness, through your auric field, the most amazing impulses, inspirations, and divine impressions for you to so bless life through your consciousness wed to the Divine Mother who loves all life free. Nonviolence, nonviolent communication, and a new harmonic of spiritual beingness is the requirement of the hour to quell the forces of darkness and to re-bestow around our world the original Edenic blueprint of light that God created and instilled and impressed upon and within our earth eons ago. Thank you, dearest ones, for your abiding presence day by day in spirit. Thank you for your resolve to be a person of peace, even a prince or princess of peace yourself, on behalf of Jesus, the Master Omram, and me. We three are invested in the true teachings of the Universal Brother Sisterhood of Light, and we will continue to teach you at inner levels to guide you through all your days in a greater understanding of the path of your soul, truly of your higher self. Finally, blessed ones, an angel of the sacred fire, comes to you each one as a servant of light to administer unto you divine communion. And this communion is the sacred essence of the Elohim, peace and aloha themselves, that they offer you an aspect of their consciousness, an essence of their being. And when you ingest this holy communion in this hour and allow it to be self-transformative, and you assimilate it in its deepest core reality, it may just be that your life will take on a new presence of love, reverence, and peace. May it be so. May it be real for you. I see and accept it on your behalf, my precious hearts, my lovely ones. I am your Kuthumi, loving you through all your days, with you in all your trials, gently caressing you through every difficulty to overcome and to remain centered and that eternal light of picture perfect peace. Thank you.